Hello dear viewer, it's time to create a compact, fast and symmetrical spaceship designed for a journey to Aquilo. Let me guide you through the construction process and highlight key aspects in order to achieve efficient and simultaneously beautiful results. First of all, we have to outline the core principles for building an effective spaceship for this task. The most important being the shape of the spaceship. In reality, acceleration and speed only depend on a ship's mass and thrust. But in Factorio, the developers have designed the game so that the width of the spaceship is the primary factor in this equation. Essentially, you can disregard the ship's mass and focus solely on its width. Height is irrelevant, which means an efficient design has to be narrow but elongated. Basically, it's like playing Ribbon World, but vertically and in space. Here's the evidence. I can increase platform size and weight vertically without affecting speed or acceleration. However, adding just one tile to the ship's width will result in a noticeable slowdown. Since our goal is to construct a fast ship for Aquilo, we need to experiment with various widths. While a wider ship simplifies construction, it also increases the speed penalty. Initially, I began with a width of 24 tiles and 5 thrusters. But eventually, after some refactoring, I settled on a width of 20 tiles and 4 thrusters. At full thrust, no quality, this ship will reach speeds of 275 km per second. We also have to think about energy production. To reach Aquilo, we must rely on nuclear energy, as solar panels are nearly ineffective at this distance from the sun. I'm utilizing 2 reactors to take advantage of the neighbor bonus, providing a maximum of 160 megawatts nuclear power. We don't need this amount of maximum power, but it allows us to double our efficiency, reducing the frequency of refueling. Setting up circuit logic to only insert fuel cells when the temperature falls below 550 degrees is essential to conserve fuel. The next thing to think about is defense. Rocket launchers are mandatory for an Aquilo trip, and we still need gun turrets to deal with small and medium asteroids. However, the positioning of our defense systems is crucial. We only care about destroying asteroids that are on a collision course with us. This is why I prefer putting rocket launchers and turrets in the horizontal center of my spaceship. I want to limit the horizontal range of my defense in order to avoid wasting ammo on asteroids that won't actually hit us. To transport materials, we use a sushi belt, but rocket launchers, turrets and the nuclear reactors are supplied directly from the main hub. It's clear why we need direct supply for the nuclear reactors, but I also prefer to keep ammunition and rockets stored in the main hub. This prevents the inserters from having to retrieve them from the sushi belt, which can lead to situations where there's no ammo available at the precise moment it needs to be restocked. Moreover, the ship is designed for the late game, so I want to have a huge amount of cargo space, which is why we are adding a significant number of cargo bays. 4 asteroid collectors in the front are sufficient, and we use a little bit of sushi belt reading and circuit trickery to only catch the asteroid types we currently need. I want 80 of each type on the belt. Asteroids don't stack, so there's no need for bulk or stack inserters. Before taking a look at asteroid processing, there's a pump to make sure there's always a minimum of over 8000 water for the nuclear reactor before it is available to the rest of the spaceship. That's over 6 minutes of water supply to make sure we don't black out, even if there's a lack of oxide asteroids. To initially start the reactor, you have to temporarily use a couple of solar panels. Let's add asteroid processing now. 2 crushers for oxide, 1 for metallic and 2 for carbonic asteroids. We are reading the sushi belt content again to activate and deactivate crushers based on the amount of already available material. The oxide and carbonic crushers change recipe from normal to advanced processing depending on the amount of calcite and sulfur on the sushi belt. Additionally, we have 2 crushers for asteroid reprocessing. Circuit logic will detect if we have an uneven distribution of asteroids on the belt and set up the proper reprocessing recipe. Making ammo requires iron plates, and since we produce calcite already, using foundries is the most efficient way to smelt iron ore. While using speed modules significantly boosts energy usage, our nuclear power supply ensures we have more than enough energy to meet the demand. We utilize stack inserters to quadruple the amount of items that can fit on the sushi belt. Not only for iron plates, but also all the materials coming from the crushers like carbon, sulfur, ice and iron ore. 2 assembling machines will craft magazines. I like to separate different kinds of products by putting them exclusively on a specific side of the belt. Processed materials left and asteroids, rockets and ammo right. At the rear end of the spaceship we use coal synthesis to make explosives for rocket production. 4 assembling machines should be sufficient while we have 1 chemical plant each producing advanced thruster fuel and oxidizer. I added thruster throttling for efficiency reasons but especially to limit the ship's speed. If you want to know how it works and how to set it up yourself, you'll find a dedicated video on thruster throttling in the top right corner and description. Depending on your research progress for physical projectile damage and stronger explosives, you can change throttling values to always travel without taking damage. With the default settings of 170 fuel per second or slightly over 40 per thruster, we travel at 200 km per second, which is recommended for physical and explosive damage level 8. When reaching level 12, you can go full thrust continuously. I placed lamps between the cargo bays for aesthetic reasons. The colors are based on the content of the sushi belt. As always, you'll find blueprints for the ship design in the description below. Going to Aquilo with over 300 km per second is desirable, because bases on this cold blue planet depend on interplanetary transportation. It's possible that I will add blueprints for a rare version of this ship later. Okay, thanks. Bye.